Hello everyone. What we're doing today is a resin pour over a framed glass. I've already applied the black, so it's quite wet still, and I'm just mixing a few contrasting colors here. I want to make it sort of a little bit elegant, and I have to try not to put too much paint in there, which is what I tend to do. I always overdo it, which still looks great but not quite how I want it. So I'm just mixing some turquoise and turquoise paint with some blue mica pigment, just to get this lovely turquoisey greeny color. I always mix my pigments and paints and alcohol inks. They all do something pretty cool. So I've got some Perlex powdered pigments, as well as Mount Mart magenta, and I have some Global copper as well, mixed with my Perlex copper. So see that it all adds to the effect, I find. And I don't believe in limitations. I think art should be limitless, and you just be creative. That's what it is, being creative. This magenta is just gorgeous, but it's taken a little bit of time to mix, which is something I don't really need. I'm just gonna grab some alcohol. Squirt a little bit of alcohol in there. Alright, it's not too bad. I'm missing one stick. Give me a second. Stick. To mix my... This is another mica pigment. It's called a gold white, which is quite transparent. I'm probably going to put this one on last. So I want to squirt a little bit of alcohol in. I've already got it in that one. Some in my turquoise. Sorry if you can't see this. I've tried to get the whole substrate in so you can see that. You don't need to see me mixing. Okay, here we go. I want to try and have a black negative space. And it helps when you leave a few drops like that. I'm going to get some of this beautiful copper. Look at that. Isn't that beautiful? Just love metallics. Take you out now. I think I already have too much paint, but oh, it's gonna be cool. I'm gonna try and do this one really quickly. I don't want to mess around with it too much. Quite transparent, so it's going straight through there. Oh no! Why? Just pick it up with a cup. Okay. And now some of this beautiful gold white. Just a little swirl. Now, I really feel like I want to put my hand in there and go swoosh, but I won't. I won't do that. What I'm going to do is I'm going to get my gun. There's quite a few bubbles here. To pull out of here. Sorry, I'm just checking to see if there's any more bubbles. I'm going to tilt it a little bit actually before I do that. So, add some black on there because I don't like that bit there. Okay. I'm tilting, but I'm being very mindful of these edges because I don't want it flipping over the edge. That would not be good at all. Oh wow, that wind's pretty crazy. I don't know if you can hear that, but yes, very, very crazy winds. It's a little bit of paint, which I haven't mixed in properly. I'm just mixing that in now. Is quite okay. What does it look like up there? I'm tempted to get my hair dryer. Goodness gracious. Ooh, did I drop it? I don't think I did. That was lucky. Very lucky. Okay, let's get this. Okay. See if I can get some more of this gold. So I've got a little bit left in there, and all I'm going to do is just give it a add some more of this of the resin, clear resin in there. And then go over a couple of areas that I want to cover. So I just use the cup then to create a little bit of interest there, which you can do, whatever you got handy. I quite like that now, it's interesting. So I'm going to leave it like this now. I'm actually going to restrain myself from doing any more fiddling, but that's what I tend to do. So less is more, just not too much of the accent paint, and oh yeah, I quite like that. So I'm gonna bring you down so you can have a look. Okay guys, so here we go. This is still wet, so it's gonna be doing its thing. See, that's that cool effect that I did with the little cup. Simple and elegant, and fingers crossed it'll dry pretty close to this. Thanks for watching, guys.